Good afternoon. There have been 11 cases of COVID-19 recorded in the Northern Territory since the last update yesterday afternoon. Five of these cases are from the recent repatriation flight from Johannesburg. They are all in the Centre for National Resilience. One is an air crew member from a recent London flight. The air crew member was in quarantine and was not infectious in the community. There is also one new case picked up in home quarantine in Darwin. The remaining four cases are linked to the Catherine cluster, bringing the cluster to 94. One, a female in her 20s who was already a close contact and in the Centre for National Resilience. The other, a male teenager who was a resident in one of the high risk streets in Catherine East, and this was detected through the testing blitz. He is being transferred to the Centre for National Resilience. And there are two cases linked to this cluster that were detected at the Royal Darwin Hospital precinct yesterday. There is a female in her 30s and her son who is aged under 10. They are residents from Timber Creek, but transited through Catherine earlier this week on their way to Darwin for scheduled surgery at RDH. As part of the pre-surgery procedures, both were tested for COVID and the results came back this morning positive. They are currently in isolation on the hospital grounds, getting the care that they need. There will be exposure sites from these two cases. We know they stayed in Catherine and they caught a bus to Darwin. We are doing the contact tracing now, and those details will be released as soon as possible today. There were 2,700 COVID tests taken in the Northern Territory in the past 24 hours, including an incredible 1,214 tests done across the Big Rivers region, an absolutely incredible result. Well done to everybody there. And we've also seen that the close contact number is at 194. 164 of these have been contacted and isolated, with 152 negative tests back so far. Kalkarindji and Dargaragu and Timber Creek and Gilwe are finishing their first day of lockout. The police commissioner will provide an update, but I'm informed that cooperation has been really good so far. Thank you to those communities for doing the right thing, for keeping yourself safe, for keeping your community safe. We will be doing another testing blitz in the streets of concern in Catherine East over the next few days to make sure we are finding every possible case that we can. And I want to remind everybody who is no longer in Catherine, but has spent time in Catherine in the past few weeks, you must get a COVID test done. Finally, as you know, in recent days, we have been working closely with a lot of stakeholders in the Territory to address some of the concerns that have been raised about new measures in place from December 20. These have been positive, productive discussions, and I thank everybody involved in them. Our land councils, our peak health bodies, our tourism and our industry groups. Working together with the health experts, we have been able to make some modest changes that should make a big difference. Bringing families together, keeping important services going, businesses open and people in work, while most importantly, still keeping the Territory safe, especially in our vulnerable communities. I want to be very clear. The big things have not changed. Everybody entering the Territory must be fully vaccinated. You must return a negative PCR test within the 72 hours before entering the Northern Territory. And you must be tested again within the first 3 days after arriving in the Territory and once more on day 6. Those rules stay the same. They are the most important health measures that we will have in place once home quarantine is removed on Monday. But we are making modest changes where recent arrivals can travel in the first 14 days following their arrival to the Northern Territory, while also having special measures in place for specific exclusion zones that are designated as more vulnerable because of current vaccination rates. These are communities that have a full vaccination rate of less than 80% for residents 5 years and over. These communities will be listed on the COVID website and other official channels. There are currently 66 communities in total. As they reach the vaccination target, they will be removed from the list.